mismatch bow tie. And I thought I would just name every single board that he went on and then sit down.
We don't have that much time.
I'm not going to do that, but but I was up late last night and I thought about it and I decided not to prove him correct about naming a savage with no chill. Taz is my friend, and I met him through Young Democrats. I'm currently the resolution chair of Young Democrats of America. I was a finance director. I met Taz at a time where I really wanted to do a fundraiser in Manhattan, I've got to be honest. And I couldn't, because Taz rose to the occasion to take over and maintain the health of that organization, which proves him to be on, being well beyond reproach. He's the most wonderful human being for keeping with the flow. Aside from all of the volunteer activities, the work that he does constantly, the warmth and compassion that he has, this moment where I can introduce my friend, I thought about what we have in common and why I feel connected to him. And I often feel like I can't share people's stories in my own. I got into politics for reasons of the heart, tragedy, pain, loss, etc. And I feel that that's the way that Taz leads. Taz is someone who brings balance to every situation. In moments of chaos, when people are too hot, he cools it down.
He's a Jedi.
When people are too icy, he warms the room. When people are too all over the place, he focuses us and he helps us secure a victory for the greater good of our democratic ethos and values. He's a brilliant mind, a gifted future lawyer, someone who I want to run for office and tried to run for something in the past. And that's where he coined me as savage with no chill. he's right. But if ever you need a place to sleep, he provides it. If ever you need an ear to listen to you, he listens. And he helps you determine how to approach any problem put forth to you in a way that harms no one and helps everyone. He brings us back to center of our core ethos as Democrats in this organization, and I'm proud to call him my friend. I hope to help him rise, cut him a check when he eventually runs, embarrass him again in the future. Everybody look at his tie and his mask. But the fact is he is amazing, and I can't possibly list all of the God. He gave me his LinkedIn so I can write this speech.
17 words.
He has a problem.
17 words, I've said it. But the fact is that at any given moment, he will be there to fight for the cause that he needs. And there's no one better for leadership. And I've gotten a lot of references for him. I know that Michael Blake finds him chill. I find him chill. I'm happy that someone in this room is found to be chill because it is not me. But there is no one better for Men of the Year. No one can raise better, knock on doors better, show up for you better, listen to you better, take your calls when he doesn't feel like it better, be there for his family with warmth and compassion better, be a friend better. No odd statistics about how there's not even 1% of representation, is that correct, in the DNC for Islamic Americans, and to bring those conversations forth to us in a way that made us acknowledge them in an incredibly important way. So it's my honor tonight, as someone who doesn't wear their heart on their sleeve, their experience on their sleeve, who is driven by their personal experience, that GAIN recognizes GAIN, and he takes every heartache that he has had, every experience that he has had, and he incorporates it into his brilliant brand of warm and balancing leadership that will make our party successful in this state, in this city, in all of our cities and the country going forward. So I'm so proud and honored just for the opportunity to tell you a little bit about Taz Mirrolin.
Don't feel like you're
funny.
still trying to get over something emotionally. So.
Well, thank you. Thank you, fellow honorees. All of you amazing people in the Rural Caucus and the Blackman chapter for all the great work that you do. Good evening, young Democrats. Good to be here. I'm honored to receive this year's New York Young Democrats Man of the Year. And I want to start by thanking a few folks. I know you're all tired and you want to kind of get out of here. But I want to thank people that helped me on the journey towards this award. First, of course, my parents and my older brother and sister, who literally have to sit there going through all of my political rants about why everything pisses me off, and the constant need to get involved in everything, like actually everything. My two other brothers, not related, but Cory Ortega and Mike Corbett, who are the very reasons why I'm in Young Democrats. I met Cory when I first joined the West Harlem Democrats, and he got me involved in the Young Democrats, where I met Mike, and he got me my first ever role doing political work across the state and canvassing. So it's grateful to have both of them in my life, both of them guide me. I'm forever grateful for them, and I'm honored to follow both of them as the Man of the Year. Both of them have received the Man of the Year in prior years. Thank you to my close friends and former board members who served with me when I was leading the Manhattan Young Democrats, specifically Grace Harmon, Quinn Kozlowski, Alicia McMahon, Kyle Ishmael, and Brian Block, who really went above and beyond during some of the most trying times of that organization. And I'll never forget what they've done for me and what they've done for the local chapter and the organization. To Patrick Jordan, who's also been a brother to me, and as you can tell, I have a very diverse extended family of all these wonderful sisters. Thank you for believing me, for supporting me, allowing me to help build the team that we have and serve as your national committee man representing New York across the country. And to Stephanie Wheaton, my very dear, dear friend who I don't see sitting there anymore. So neither of us remember how we met. We keep having to like have these conversations of where we actually met, and we don't really remember. But what I do remember is one of the very first things she told me is that we're gonna be best friends. You just don't know it yet. and I can guarantee we are best friends. She's basically a sister to me. And I honestly couldn't imagine doing any of the work that I do for Democrats across the state without her being in my life. So thank you, Steph. I'll thank her in person later. To Stacey Aliak, who's also a contributor. For being my partner in crime, traveling across the country together, occasionally having to deal with some of my snoring. thanks to my dear friend Seamus Campbell, who's also been a rock to me and my support, for always taking his shot at every Hamilton reference possible.
Yes.
That's kind of meta because taking his shot. As well as my friends Mike and Javon and all of the members of the New York State Executive Board. It's like a really long list, so we can just look. It's in the book, you can look at the book. You guys have been amazing to me and for the rest of the E-Board, as well as all of the local friends that I've made in local politics and the DNC, including my brother Michael Blake. He's basically the best human being on the planet, and that man is gonna run for president one day. You heard it here first. he's been an inspiration to me and support of my journey, so I really wanna shout out all of the support you've given me in my life. And to all of the people that I can't name, you all know who you are, I love you. So there are days that I ask myself, you know, why bother? Why do we do this? What makes me wanna get up and fight? What makes me wanna go out there, knock on these doors, make these phone calls, raise this money, deal with the amount of BS that gets thrown at me for the color of my skin, for my name, the discrimination and the hatred directed at me from everyday people all the way up to the president of the United States? Well, the answer is simple. It's right here.
Yeah.
the Young Democrats. It's an organization born from a desire to get involved because decisions were being made without us being involved. You are the young, the scrappy, and the hungry leaders I look to, the voices that inspire me, and it's your ideas that push us forward and is going to lead this country. In these trying times, we must take up the mantle of leadership, that's all of you have, and inspire others when our government does it. This room is full of individuals that have profoundly changed this state's politics and will continue to change America's politics. And I am proud to stand with you every single day. So tonight's a good night to be a Democrat. I'm proud to be a Democrat because this party fights for my values. They fight for me to have my voice. They fight to protect my family. They fight to advance our rights. And they fight for me to have the promise in America that I still believe in. It's because I am a Democrat, I'm proud that I'm public school educated from first grade all the way to law school. Because I am a son of immigrants, and my parents came to this country from a war-torn country believing in a better life.
Yes.
And I'm a damn proud Democrat because I'm a Muslim American and this is my home. So I say to all you amazing Democrats here, Democrats around the country, and especially to the new generation of young leaders, especially to the ones fighting for gun violence prevention, and they had a march today across Brooklyn Bridge, so we all should recognize that. My message to them is to believe in the beauty of your dreams, to believe in yourself, and the future will be yours. You will win. So thank you for believing in me, for uplifting me, for supporting, supporting the work we do that often goes unnoticed but has a measurable impact. Thank you so much, and God bless you all.